Hello, today should be a pretty quick lesson. We're talking about equations and mental math. This is our seventh video and our final video for this unit, and it comes from our book, Chapter 1, Lesson 6. So let's go ahead and get started. First of all, what is an equation? An equation is simply a number sentence with an equal sign. Pretty easy. Equation sounds like equal. And so it is just a number sentence with an equal sign. That's what an equation is. Remember, a number sentence has numbers and some kind of operation. So we put a number sentence between, or an equation is a number sentence with an equal sign. That's pretty much all you need to know about that. Solution, again, a solution sounds pretty simple. A lot of kids will say it's the answer, and that's right, but it's only partially right. We got to make sure that that answer is correct. So it is an answer to a math expression, so to a math problem, we'll just say. An answer to a math problem that makes the statement true. There's the key part. It has to make the statement true. Sorry, I'm having a problem here. That makes the statement. That's really ugly. I'm gonna try that again. Sorry about that. The solution is an answer to a math problem that makes the statement true. So a lot of times you give me what you think is a solution, but it's not the right answer. So it's not a solution unless it makes the problem true. So for example here, to be very elementary here, if I said 3 plus what number equals 7, I could tell you that x equals 5. But would that make the sentence true? 3 plus 5 equals 7? No, 3 plus 5 is 8. So that would not be a solution. You might have given it as an answer, but it's not a solution. The solution to this would be x equals 4. That's what makes the math sentence true. So let's go on. Is the last number in a solution to the equation? If we were to take 4 and to plug it in here, would it make the sentence true? Let's check it out. Remember 3x, that means 3 times x. When we substitute that 4 in, we're going to take 3 times 4 plus 4 equals 19. Well, order of operations, I have to do this first. 3 times 4 is 12. 12 plus 4, does that equal 19? 12 plus 4 is, 16. 16 does not equal 19. So this would be false. How about the next one? If z equaled 12, would this be true? Is 12 a solution here? We're going to go ahead and plug this in and see what we get. 5 plus 12 equals 17. 5 plus 12 is 17. 17 equals 17. Therefore, yay, this one is in fact true. So that's pretty easy. How about here? We're also talking about mental math. Some of these you need to get in the habit of doing in your head if you can. Now, if you can't do things in your head, that certainly works, but you want to try and do as much in your head as you can because it's a lot faster than having to get out your calculator or write it down. So here, let's check it out. What number plus 10 equals 24? What number can I come up with plus 10 equals 24? I hope you came up with 14. 14 plus 10 equals 24. Let's try the next one. 9 times what number is going to give us 54?
9 times what equals 54? That's how I figure out these variables, is I just say what number, or ask myself, what number can I take to make the equation true? So 9 times 6 is equal to 54. Now, last but not least, what number, when I subtract 4 from it, gives me 62? Well, 66 minus 4 equals 62. Good job. How about these last ones? I want you to try these on your own, and I'll see you tomorrow in class.